everyone, it's Vicky. Welcome to One Book July, and we are in our seventh year, which is so hard to believe that we are in our seventh year of One Book July. Myself, Romany, Carrie Harling, and now Michelle from Everyday TV. We are back again this year. We kind of hemmed and hawed whether or not we should do this, should we not do this, just based on everything that's happening in the world. And we ultimately came to the decision that we really should allow for some kind of a little relief, hopefully, and give people something to look forward to and something to either watch along or partake in. If you're new to One Book July, please check out all of the last 6 years that we've been doing this challenge. But basically, Romany, myself, and Carrie, we got together 6 years ago and thought, how can we answer all the questions that we were getting hit with in the planner community based around the fact that, how do I plan? Do I need the stickers? Do I need to invest in all of the accoutrements that come along with planning? And we basically tried to just kind of bring it to the core, bring it to the most simplest form, and that was just one pen and one notebook. And that really would force individuals to only focus on the actual planning portion. That was really the original idea and plan behind One Book July. That's really why we started it, was to really help in a widespread format bring across to the community what it was to really just plan just that. And then as you get comfortable in your system and what planning was, you can reintroduce all the accoutrements, all the fun stickers, the washi tape, all that great stuff can kind of really come back into your system after you found what you wanted, that so you weren't just lost in the fluff. You really knew what your foundation was, and then you can bring everything in. And that's really why we started the challenge. But moving forward, every year we had added to the challenge, whether it was a project, a digital format, we had added to the project every year. And this year, drum roll please, this year we are going to do something a bit of a buffet style called the pick and mix kind of challenge. And really what that means is we're all kind of doing something different. Myself, what I'm going to be doing this year is I am going to be revisiting last year's challenge, meaning last year what I did was we read the Writer Carol bullet journal book and we took and interpreted that reading into the way that we were going to be bullet journaling and planning it. I have truly not changed my system it's going to be 3 years in November. So that's huge for me, because I was constantly changing up my systems or tweaking them. My system is really staying the same. The only things that are changing are the actual little notebooks and planners. That constantly changes all the time. But the actual two book system that I have now been going strong in for 2.5 years is my everything, and it's really changed my life. I will have a setup for you. I'll show you everything. If you are a Patreon, then it's not going to be super new to you because you see me doing this already. But for those of you who aren't, it's going to be kind of a newer concept for you. But the two book system really works well and really strong. I'm going to really break it down for you this month in July. So I'm really going to break it down to exactly how I've separated the bullet journal portion and the planner portion. In my opinion, the kind of main thing that I can give you from my reading Writer Carol's book was that it really wasn't necessarily intended to be just a planner. It was the bullet journal method was intended to help organize your thoughts. So after you've organized your thoughts, then I go to my planner to really execute. So that's how I've separated the system. And of course, I will break it down, have the nitty gritty. I even will have mind maps and things like that to show you, hopefully in a visual format, of what I'm talking about, not just give you, like, I'll give you examples, but I'm going to try and do it that way. So we're going to revisit. We're going to see, what did the book do for us? Did we adopt the challenge? What does it look like 1 year later? What does that look like? So I'm going to go through that. I'm of course going to revisit some of the things that I've loved in years past with One Book July. So I'm going to do definitely a memory lane kind of a visit, because this is such a awesome time. I love One Book July, and I've loved the challenges we've done in the past. I've not hated any of them, and I love what all of you in the community bring to the challenge. It's always been really great fun to see that. And then Carie Harling is going to be reading a book, and she will be out at her video, so you can listen to her and how she explains everything. And then of course Romany does a really beautiful job of explaining everything every year. She does an awesome job, so I'm gonna leave her link down below as well, because she's gonna explain what she's gonna be doing. There's a couple of things she's gonna be, will have lots on her channel also, so please be sure to check hers out to see what she's doing. And then Michelle from Everyday Awesome TV, I believe she's gonna be reading along with Carie as well, as putting a digital spin on things, because that's her thing. She knows digital the best, and you know, we've loved having her included so that she can give a digital kind of look into things as well, not just the analog. So you guys please pick and choose all of us, one of us, somebody who you think you're gonna want to either do the challenge with or just watch along. I love seeing everyone's challenges, and I love seeing what everyone does on here. Please be sure to use the hashtag OneBookJuly2020 so that we can find you, so that everyone else in the community can find you on there as well. We can see what each of us is doing. If you liked one of the past challenges, feel free to do one of those. There's never any rules. They're just guidelines to really kind of help you, bring forward what really we intended initially the first year that we did it, which was what is planning and how do you plan, was just to kind of break that down. But you guys do whatever you'd like. Again, it's a buffet style, so you pick and choose. If you want to read the book, if you don't want to read a book, if you want to check out last year's challenge, it's totally and completely up to you. It's supposed to be fun. We all would like to do it as a community, and that's the whole point of it, is just to do it as a community and to enjoy it. So this was just a quick intro video. I will have a setup coming up for you very soon. I will be starting it. I mean, there's nothing I'm changing really. So I don't like officially start anything like on, you know, the June 29th or June 30th or July 1st or anything like that, because I've technically been doing this already for the past 2.5 years. But choose your date and go, whether you want to do it today, tomorrow, you know, the actual July 1st, whatever you want to do. Just go for it, get it going, get started, and get excited about it, and look for more videos from myself, from Carie, from Romany, and from Michelle. Check us all out, have fun, and I'll see you again soon. Take care. Bye-bye.